Film Recap here. Today I'm gonna explain a horror thriller movie called Saw. Watch out, spoilers ahead. The movie starts with a man waking in a bathtub filled with water. He sits up, not noticing that as he does, he pulls the plug out and something that was floating above him goes down the drain. He gets out and starts shouting for help, until he hears another man in the room with him. The man finds the light switch and turns it on. The two men see in the middle of the room, a dead man, with a gun in one hand and a tape recorder in the other. He has recently blown his own brains out. The two men make more talk on who they are. The man in the bathtub's name is Adam, Leigh Whannell, and the other man is Dr. Lawrence Gordon, Cary Elwes. Neither remembers how they got there. Each of them is chained to a pipe, at opposite ends of what looks like a bathroom. There seems to be no way out. Lawrence tries and fails to open a door. After a while they each find in their pockets a tape. Lawrence also finds a bullet and a key with his. Both men try and fail to unlock their shackles with it. Adam constructs a reaching device from his shirt and the plug from the bath to hook the tape recorder out of the man's hand, and play his tape on it. Lawrence notices a heart drawn on the toilet tank, in which Adam finds a black bag containing two saws. He throws one to Lawrence and both men attempt to saw through their chains. Adam's saw breaks, and Lawrence realizes that the idea is for them to saw through their legs. He tells Adam he thinks they have been captured by the Jigsaw killer, and that he was once a suspect. The movie flashes back to several cops, Detective Tapp, his partner Detective Singh and some others. They are at a murder scene, being told by a cop named Cary exactly what happened. A man was trapped in the middle of the room, surrounded by barbed wire. There is another flashback. We see the victim wake up in the room, and told by the same voice from the earlier tapes that if he wants to escape, he has to find a path through the barbed wire before the door to the room locks in 2 hours. Evidently the man didn't make it through the wire, he is hanging from it, cut to pieces. We then see another victim, a man who was incinerated after a candle caught fire to the flammable liquid he was covered in, while he was trying to find on the wall of the room he was in a safe combination, the safe containing the antidote to the poison in him. Cary tells Tapp and Singh they found a peephole at the scene, indicating the killer watches his victims. They also found a penlight, which they conclude belongs to Lawrence. Lawrence is brought in for questioning while he is at work in a hospital. He angers an orderly named Zepp concerning a dying patient named John. At the police station, Lawrence tells the police he was with someone else the night the incinerated man died. Tapp brings in a woman who survived her run-in with Jigsaw and makes her tell Lawrence her story. A further flashback shows the woman, Amanda, Shawnee Smith, wake up in a room with a device fitted to her face. A TV next to her shows a creepy clown puppet tell her that the key to the device is in the stomach of the dead man in the cell with her, and if she doesn't unlock it within a minute, the device will explode and rip her face apart. She gets up, which starts the timer, and finds a knife next to the man, who is actually not dead, and wakes up. Amanda stabs him and cuts him open, sifting through his guts until she finds the key, unlocks the device and throws it on the ground, just as it explodes. Lawrence, meanwhile, is let go. We go back to Adam and Lawrence. After realizing the mirror in the room is two-way, they smash it and find a camera behind it, through which Jigsaw is watching them. Lawrence tells Adam about his family. There's a flashback to the last time Lawrence saw them. His daughter Diana thought there was someone in her room. Lawrence searched the room for her and after finding nothing, gets paged by work, actually the med student he's having an affair with, and has to leave, not before arguing with his wife Allison. Back in the room, Lawrence shows Adam pictures in his wallet of Diana. Adam finds a Polaroid of Diana and Allison tied up and gagged, with a message on the back X marks the spot, sometimes you see things better with your eyes closed. Adam hides the picture and throws the wallet back to Lawrence. Another flashback shows that just after Lawrence left for work, Allison goes to Diana's room and finds a man covered in a sheet attacking Diana. The man knocks them both out, ties them up and gags them. There is a flashback to Tapp and Singh still trying to solve the case. Tapp watches the video that Amanda saw, hearing a fire alarm in the background and seeing graffiti on the walls. Using this, the men track down the building it was filmed at. When they get there, they find a model mock-up of Adam and Lawrence in the room, the clown puppet and a pig's head mask. They also find a man, still alive, strapped into a chair with a drill on either side of his head. Tapp and Singh hide when they hear the killer, dressed in a cloak, come up the stairs. Tapp and Singh leap out at him, but the killer pushes a button that starts the drills and tells them there are a bunch of keys in the box next to them. One of them will release the man. Singh tries to unlock the man, while Tapp attempts to arrest Jigsaw. Singh eventually shoots the drills, saving the man, and Jigsaw slashes Tap's throat, escaping. Singh chases and shoots him, but trips a wire that sets off several other guns, killing him. Jigsaw gets up and walks away. Back with Adam and Lawrence, Adam tells Lawrence to turn the lights out. When he does, a glow-in-the-dark X can be seen on the wall behind Lawrence. He smashes through the tiles and finds a box, using the key from earlier to unlock it. Inside is a mobile/cell phone, which can only receive calls, a note, two cigarettes and a lighter. Adam asks for the cigarette, as Lawrence reads the note, which basically says that the dead man in the room had poison in his blood, and if Lawrence dips the cigarette in it and gives it to Adam, he will himself be poisoned. The phone rings, It's Jigsaw forcing Diana and Allison to speak to Lawrence. Allison tells Lawrence not to believe anything Adam says, and that he already knew him. The phone goes dead and Lawrence questions Adam. It turns out Adam was being paid by Tap, who survived, to follow Lawrence and take photos of him. We flash back to very creepy scene showing how Lawrence and Adam were captured by Jigsaw. Somehow, Lawrence works out that Zep, the orderly from before, is Jigsaw. He tries to trick Zep by dipping one of the cigarettes in the blood, then turning the lights out and whispering to Adam to play along. He turns the lights back on and offers Adam a cigarette, giving him the unbloodied one. Adam smokes it and pretends to die. However, he screams when he is electrocuted through his shackles. He and Adam realize it's 6 p.m., and Zep goes to kill Diana and Allison, who have managed to free themselves. Zep phones Lawrence, who freaks out when he hears Allison and Zep fight and scream. Suddenly, Tap, who was discharged from the police after the investigation into Jigsaw drove him crazy, and had been watching Lawrence's house through a surveillance video, appears and gets into a shootout with Zep. Allison and Diana escape. Zep runs out of the house and Tap chases. Lawrence meanwhile has completely lost it, believing his family has been killed. He saws his own foot off, crawls over to the dead man's gun, loads it with the bullet and shoots at him. Outside the room, Zep and Tap are in a tussle. Zep shoots Tap, killing him. He opens the door to the room, and is about to kill Lawrence when Adam grabs him and beats him over the head with the lid of the toilet tank, killing him. Lawrence tells Adam he will go for help, or they'll both bleed to death. He crawls away, and just after he does, Adam finds a tape recorder on Zep. The voice on the tape is that of Jigsaw, telling Zep that to get the antidote for the poison in him, he will have to set up the situation with Lawrence, his family and Adam. Behind Adam, the dead man suddenly stands up, pulling a mask off, and revealing himself to be John, the patient from earlier. Kramer is the real Jigsaw killer. He reveals that the key to Adam's chain went down the bathtub drain when Adam first woke up. Adam attempts to shoot Jigsaw with Zep's gun, but Jigsaw shocks him with a remote. Jigsaw turns to leave and turns off the lights. He yells game over before sealing the door and leaving a screaming Adam to die. Thanks for watching and like and subscribe to watch more videos like this.